Breaking news that's coming in a week after the family of a 28-year-old man in Kanpur alleged that a team of cops failed to stop his kidnappers from escaping with the 30 lakh ransom. Four cops, including an additional SP rank officer, have been suspended. Police claim that no money was given to the kidnappers and that the man was killed by the kidnappers last month. The family alleged it was the cops themselves who had asked them to arrange for the ransom. The deceased Sanjeet Yadav's body, however, has still not been recovered. Meanwhile, five people have been arrested in connection with the alleged kidnapping and murder of the lab technician in Kanpur. The victim, Sanjeet Yadav, worked as a technician at a private lab. He was allegedly kidnapped on June 22nd by two men who used to work in the same lab. Now, according to the police, the kidnappers killed Sanjeet on June 26th and threw his body into a canal. And on the 29th of June, they demanded a ransom of 30 lakhs from Sanjeet's family.
कल पुलिस को पांच अभियुक्तों को गिरफ्तार करने में सफलता हासिल हुई है इसमें ज्ञानेंद्र यादव कुलदीप नीलू रामजी और प्रीति ये पांच अभियुक्त इसमें गिरफ्तार हुए हैं इस घटना का मास्टरमाइंड ज्ञानेंद्र यादव निकला है जिस लैब में संजीत यादव काम करता था पूर्व में उसी लैब में ये व्यक्ति भी काम करते थे और पूर्व से ही इस अपहृत व्यक्ति के जानकार थे उसके दोस्त थे इन लोगों ने योजनाबद्ध तरीके से एक मकान किराए पर लिया जिसमें दो महिलाओं का भी इन्वॉल्वमेंट आया है जिसमें से एक महिला गिरफ्तार की जा चुकी है अपहरण करने के बाद 22 तारीख को इन्होंने अपहृत व्यक्ति को उस मकान में रखा 26 तारीख की रात्रि में 26 जून की रात्रि में जब अपहृत व्यक्ति ने भागने का प्रयास किया तो उसके पश्चात इन लोगों ने निर्णय लिया कि इस व्यक्ति को मार दिया जाए और 27 तारीख की सुबह ही इस व्यक्ति की इन्होंने गला दबा करके हत्या कर दी इसके बाद नहर में इसके डेड बॉडी को इन्होंने फेंक दिया
All right, moving on now, a tragic incident has come to light in Tamil Nadu where two children were found dead after getting stuck inside an unused car. Now, the children aged 3 years old and 7 years old reportedly entered an unused Maruti Swift car while playing near their homes. In fact, the parents found their children inside the car after they went missing for several hours. The children were taken to a hospital but declared dead on arrival. Now, the Tamil Nadu police have initiated an investigation into this entire incident. And moving on to the latest developments as far as the state of Assam is concerned, remember it has been reeling under the effects of floods. The state government has set up 587 relief camps across the state. A state government has revealed that over 56 lakh people have been affected due to the floods in 26 districts of Assam. The natural calamity has claimed more than 119 lives so far, while 93 people drowned, 26 others were killed in landslides. The Brahmaputra River, meanwhile, continues to flow above the danger mark, and early estimates suggest that nearly 1.19 lakh hectares of crop area have been damaged across Assam. Meanwhile, as Kaziranga National Park remains flooded, the officials have expressed their concerns over the high frequency of floods seen in the area. In a month alone, three floods have hit the prestigious national park. Officials are monitoring the situation closely as several rhinos were also seen at the riverbank today in the national park as well.
This is the third wave of witnessing Kaziranga within a month. First flood started in 26 June last, and this is the third flood. So, as far as flood is concerned, I think this is a very unique frequency. Frequency is very, very high. in shortest period, we faced three round of flood.
Meanwhile, despite a number of shelter camps being set up and people living in those shelter camps, they still say that they are finding it difficult as the resources that they're being provided with are not enough. My colleague Arindam filed this report from Kamrup.
Right now, I am going to show you the story of the plight of the flood-affected people who are taking shelter on various river embankments. We are right now at Hajo, and this is the embankment of River Lakhetara. These people who fled their villages when flash floods created havoc in their villages are taking shelter on this river embankment. To know more about this, their plight, let me straight away ask one of the flood-affected victims how this flood fury has been for them and how they are living in this condition. Tell me, what kind of people are you living here?
Yes, yeah. गुजरा तो बहुत तकलीफ से कर रहे हो हम लोग. अभी ऊपर से लॉकडाउन चल रहा है और नीचे से ये पानी जमीन सब फेंक गया है. अभी हम लोग ऊपर रोड पर आना पड़ रहा है. सरकार बोल रहा है कि हम लोग बहुत कुछ दिया है, बहुत कुछ लिया है, ऐसे बोल रहा है. आके देखना चाहिए क्या क्या मिल रहा है हम लोग, क्या नहीं मिल रहा है, ये देखना चाहिए.
So there you have heard from one of the flood victim. He is alleging that nobody from the administration have turned up to take stock of their situation or provide any sort of help or relief material. They are just provided with some meager amount of relief material among the various villages. And let me show you the condition that these people are right now forced to live in. This is the temporary shed that they have set up by themselves when flash floods created havoc in their villages. And as you can see, they are right now coexisting along with their cattle and poultry in these sheds that they have set up by themselves. So these people don't know when they will be able to go back to their villages, because though the flood waters have receded, that is not helping much, because there is deep siltation in their villages. That the houses are destroyed, the agricultural fields, there is deep siltation, and almost everything they have lost. So to start life again for normalcy would be a very difficult task for them. And as this person have alleged that nobody from the administration have turned up to provide any sort of help or relief material. These are the houses which they abandoned when flash floods created havoc. So many of them have come from distant areas also, and this is the only high ground that is available right now amidst flood waters, and this is the only safe shelter they have found to take shelter. And even in on this high embankment, they don't know even if the flood waters come to this level also.
Meanwhile, another state to be facing the wrath of floods is Bihar. Heavy incessant rains coupled with floods have wreaked havoc in Bihar. As many as 7.65 lakh people have been impacted as a result of these floods, and over 13,800 people have been shifted to shelter homes. River Gandak continues to flow in full spate. 21 teams of the National Disaster Response Force and State Disaster Response Force have been deployed in the state, and train services, meanwhile, have been stopped between Darbhanga and Samastipur. Meanwhile, days after the Sattarghat bridge approach road in Bihar collapsed last week, another similar incident from Gopalganj. Now, the approach road of the Gopalganj bridge has also been washed away. Now, this particular bridge was inaugurated by the Chief Minister in March of 2016 and set up at a cost of 548 crore. Now, significantly, both these bridges were constructed by the same contractor. Meanwhile, the flood situation, as we pointed out, in Bihar's Gopalganj as well, remains severe. Moving on now to the city of Mumbai, where after complaints of hefty power bills, consumers have now received a disconnection warning from the Mumbai Electricity Supply Body, BEST. Now, the message reads that while BEST may not cut the power supply immediately, consumers must pay their bills at the earliest. Now, this warning comes despite the state government's directive to not disconnect power supply. Consumers have also alleged that BEST is asking them to pay half the bill amount in one installment, which violates the state government order or guideline that permits three installments to make the payment of the bills. Meanwhile, outrage over inflated electricity bill rates in Mumbai continues. On Thursday, at least 15 BJP corporators created a ruckus at the Best General Manager's office. Best, remember, is the government electricity provider in Mumbai. Corporators protested against a delayed redressal and disconnection notice served to some of the consumers. The corporators also gave out the general manager, who then had to escape his office with the help of the police.
Consumers of BEST power supply were quite disappointed when many of them were served a message saying that their supply connection will be disconnected if they do not pay their bill within the deadline. The message also said that while the disconnection may not happen immediately, but they should pay their bills at the earliest. In fact, some consumers have also said that there is no proper guideline being given as to how is it that they are being charged as heavy tariffs, and at the same time, what is the bifurcation that is going on. At the earliest, we also understand that the government had said that these consumers can pay the bills in either three installments, but many consumers are saying that they've been asked to pay the bill full or at least half, and a lot of confusion still prevails. Like, for example, I am outside the Dadar's BEST power office, and you can see the queue of people here asking clarity over their bills. Many have come here because even after paying the hefty amount of bill for the month of June, they were still served a high charge bill even for the month of July, and that is why they have come here to demand clarification. Others are saying that the helpline numbers of BEST are not really helping them to get their doubts cleared, and which is why consumers of BEST have lined up here to demand clarification. A similar situation was witnessed in BEST General Manager's office yesterday when BJP leaders along with some consumers reached his office, but no clarity was given even there. With video journalist Rajesh, this is Neha for Mirror Now from Mumbai.
On that note, we're going to slip into a very quick break, but lots more news coming up on the other side. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Now, witnessing the constant rise in the number of COVID cases, the Mumbai civic body has decided to change its COVID policy in the suburbs. Mumbai civic body has decided to go back to its earlier policy of sealing the entire building, or at least the entire wing of a society, even if a single person is found to be COVID positive. Now, authorities found that some of the locals were going out to buy essentials, and so they have decided to do antigen testing as well of shopkeepers, chemists and grocers in the area. Those, of course, are the details coming in at this point in time. Neha is joining me for more on this. Neha, if you can take us through the latest developments here.
Absolutely. So this move is coming, Avni, in the wake of the fact that the BMC Corporation is saying that the lockdown rule which must be followed in these sealed areas, that is not happening. So the last amendment rule that BMC came out was only the specific floor of the building will be sealed, and all those people will not be allowed to move out of their homes, and all the essentials will be delivered to their homes. But now some officials are seeing that people are not just coming out of the building, they're also moving to the nearby stores and nearby areas here and there, and even those people are getting infected. So to avoid all of this, the two decisions have been taken in certain buildings of the suburbs, that either you seal the entire building or that specific wing of the building. And some cases have been seen in Dahisar and Kandivali area where this has been done as of now. And the BMC is also saying that in high rises, the cases are going up by 30% to 40%. So they have to take this move. We understand that in other areas of the suburbs, this move will be repeated again, because people are not following the social distancing norms and are not following the norms of when the buildings get sealed, you all should remain inside and not come out, even if it is for essential reasons.
All right, Neha, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. And this is news that's just coming in. After an initial flurry of action, Maharashtra government may have gone easy on cracking down on hoarders. The Maharashtra FDA minister has expressed concerns about key drugs like remdesivir being illegally sold at almost five times the cost in some areas. The minister also highlighted shortage of staff among some of the challenges in front of the government.
Mumbai and Upnagar जो आप अभी आपने बात की, पुणे हो, नासिक हो या औरंगाबाद में भी कुछ कंप्लेंट्स हमारी तरफ आ रही है। जैसे जैसे पेशेंट्स बढ़ रहे हैं, वैसे वैसे इस रेमडेसिविर और टोस्टलीजुमाब की डिमांड भी बढ़ रही है, और मुंबई छोड़कर भी पुणे, नासिक, औरंगाबाद यहाँ भी कुछ तकरार आई है कि ज़्यादा रेट्स पर यहाँ पर रेमडेसिविर और टोस्टलीजुमाब बेचे जा रहे हैं। हमारे विभाग में लोगों की कमी होने के कारण हम ज़्यादा इस पर कार्रवाई नहीं कर सक रहे, लेकिन पुलिस के माध्यम से आगे आने वाले दिनों में हम सब मिलकर इस पर बाकी शहरों में भी हम इस बारे में काम करेंगे।
My colleague Mayuresh is joining me for more on this. Mayuresh, what are you picking up in terms of how the government is going to be dealing with those who are indulging in black marketing of these drugs?
See, when we had word with the FDA Minister, Mr. Shingne, he clearly told us that they have a shortage of staff, and also information is not coming in that way so that they can conduct the raids. Right now, he told us that after Mumbai, now Nasik, Pune and the Aurangabad city, the complaints are coming from that particular region, but they don't have the exact information, and that's why they have asked Home Minister to help with the police officials, especially with the crime branch, because crime branch gets these kind of tip-offs with the network of their informers. So FDA Minister has requested Maharashtra CM and Home Minister to ask the crime branch and the local police to help them to conduct the raids.
All right, Mayuresh, thank you so much for joining us with those details. And this is the latest news that's coming in as far as Sushant Singh Rajput death case is concerned. The Mumbai police has issued second summons to actress Kangana Ranaut. The police has sent summons to the actress via post and has been sent to her Manali address. Remember earlier, the police did say that Kangana's team was not cooperating and that they had struggled to issue summons to the actor. Santhya is joining us for more details on this. Santhya, if you can take us through the latest developments here. The Mumbai police are seeming to have issued second set of summons to Kangana Ranaut.
Yes, Avni, and the second set of summons were issued by Mumbai police today itself, and they were sent to Kangana's Manali address via post. But within 1 hour of that, a mail was sent to Mumbai police by the lawyer of Kangana Ranaut, and he has referred to another summons issued by Mumbai police, and he has said that Mumbai police has asked Kangana Ranaut to remain present and come to police station to record her statement anywhere between 27th July to 31st of July. But in his response on her behalf, he has said, the lawyer has said, that Kangana is right now in Manali and cannot travel to Mumbai because of coronavirus situation and the lockdown. And that's why he has requested Mumbai police to either send a set of questions so that she can answer accordingly, or send a team to Manali. Same thing which was actually said by Rangoli on a chat, which was mentioned in a tweet by Kangana's team itself. So the lawyer also repeated the same words, either send a team to Manali to record the statement or send a questionnaire, or one option which this time the lawyer has given, that either record her statement via video conferencing. So these are the options which are given by Kangana's lawyer to Mumbai police, which clearly, once again, it mentions that Kangana cannot come to Mumbai to record her statement. She cannot remain physically present for that. Avni.
Yes, absolutely, Santhya. In fact, while we have you with us, if you can just give us an update on the entire case, because there have been multiple summons issued and other summons to celebrities are also perhaps something we could watch out for in the coming days.
See, in Sushant Singh Rajput suicide case, more than 40 people's statements have been recorded so far. And that includes Aditya Chopra, Sanjay Leela Bhansali. In fact, filmmaker Shekhar Kapoor has mailed his statement to Mumbai police. Apart from that, statements of Sushant's family, his team, his lawyers, his friends are recorded by Mumbai police so far. In the near future as well, Mumbai police believes that they are likely to call some more directors from the industry to record their statement. But as of now, 40 plus people have recorded their statements in the case so far, Avni.
All right, Santhia, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. And on that note, it's time to wrap up this edition. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned tomorrow night.